Hi, my name is Akiva Goldman. I'm the director and founder of Goldman and Associates. Our firm has a primary focus on family law issues here in Michigan, and today we're continuing our video series designed to educate and inform the public, so please subscribe to our channel. We are often asked with the question, and we are tasked with the challenge, of a client whose ex wants to move out of town, wants to relocate to a different state with the child. It's always, how can I prevent it? Well, it's really a misnomer. It's not a question of how you can prevent it so much as will the court allow it. You see, in a situation where one person has custody of the child, and the other one has parenting time, if the person with the custody wants to, let's say, move to Florida, they have to file a motion to get the court to allow them to change the residency of the child. Now, they can move wherever they want anytime. But if they're going to tow a child with them, they're going to need permission of the court, even if they have custody. And that means that they're going to have to file a petition. And it's not some kind of petition, by the way, that's a form where you check off boxes. I want to leave. Let me go. It's not that kind of thing. When our firm prepares those petitions, they're an inch thick. They take into account various things that the court wants to know about in considering relocation. They take into account, for example, the respective school systems, which one's better. They take into account the crime rates in the area, the socioeconomics in the area. Where are you going to live in relation to the kind of place you have right now? How close will you be with family and friends? Will you be uprooted from local family when you go to Florida? That kind of thing, and the court wants to know about that. So when we talk about how can I prevent my ex from moving, well, what you've got to do is be prepared to address those issues and to say, look, there's no compelling reason to move. The job that she wants to take there is readily available here. The school system there is not nearly as good as what the child is doing right now, or in the alternative, child has special needs that are being met in the current school system, won't be met in the other system. That's a more dangerous area. The cost of living is so much higher, which means the housing is going to be really hard to get decent housing. So instead of having his own space, the kid's doubling up. You know, those kind of things the court will take into account. And why? Because ultimately the court has to determine, is it in the best interest of the child to make the move? So if you want to prevent your ex from relocating, you've got to address those issues and you've got to be able to answer that petition and say, look, everything is so much better here. There's no family out here. There's a huge family that's going to be very much hurt by the departure of this child. The child has friends here. The child has social relations here in the way of classmates, friends from the neighborhood that he or she is going to miss and now start all over again in a new place. And for what? So this person can take a job and make a few dollars more? The court doesn't usually see that as a way of furthering the best interests of the child. So when you talk about combating these kinds of motions to prevent the relocation, if that's what you want to do, you've got to be prepared to address these issues. If you need assistance in that regard, of course, reach out and we'll be glad to help you out.